Also wir sind hier in Winterthur im Gaswerk und zwar nach dem Konzert von den Toasters in, genau, im Backstage-Raum. Und Mr. Hingley, habe ich jetzt vernommen und auch auf der Bühne gehört, hat ein paar deutsche Worte. So, first question, why do you speak German?
How do I speak German? Als ich Kind war, mein Vater war Mitglieder von den britischen Besatzungsarmee in Deutschland in den 60er Jahren. Doch habe ich mich ein bisschen Deutsch gekriegt, als ich 5 Jahre alt war.
Okay, so...
Aber das ist kein Swiss-Deutsch.
No, no, actually, I'm from Germany, so I couldn't understand them as well. But, yeah, let's start with the show. How do you feel about it?
Well, I think people in Switzerland smoke a lot of cigarettes. That's what I think. And so now I have to wash all my clothes because I smell like an ashtray. But they're great. Swiss kids are very, 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 very enthusiastic. They like to come on stage and smash everything up. It's great.
So, do you think it was a good show? It was a small venue, but I think it was packed and, better than half packed or something.
Well, here's what, I mean, we like to play all kinds of shows, and sometimes when we play the real big venues, like, you know, football stadiums and real big auditoriums, there's no atmosphere at all. So sometimes when you play in front of 10,000, 20,000 people, it's a bad concert because there's just no, how do you say, there's no mood. You know, no feeling. But when you get in a little sweaty room and everybody's up in your face, then you can put on a really good show because it doesn't matter if there's 5 people or 5,000 people. It's all about the energy that you get from the audience. And in the big shows, you don't get that back. So das bekommen wir nicht in große Schauen.
Oh, great that you say that. And what do you... Because... I don't know if you remember, but I saw you in London in the 101 club or something, and 2 weeks later I saw you in Leipzig, so it was complete different. So on the in London it was half packed, and in Leipzig it was the Dynamite Sky Festival, and it was completely packed and it was great. So what does it make a good performance for you?
Well, different because when we're in Leipzig in front of, like, what, 1,200 people, and that's fantastic for that. But also, it's a different vibe because when we play in the 101 Club in London, that where, you know, bands like the Sex Pistols and the Rolling Stones and the Beatles and Standen, yeah, then you have to respect that. So it's a different vibe. But you know... I have to say that the 101 Club was a great show because there were like, what, 200 people maybe? So a small show, but so much feeling and so much power in the venue that you have to, it's like the CBGBs of London, so you derive energy from that. But at Leipzig, you with 1,200 people, you derive the energy from the crowd because there's so many people having a good time. So different shows have a different dynamic every time.
So you have been for so long in the business and been around the world. What makes a venue special?
It's always the people, you know, because, you know, people say this is a good venue or that's a good venue. I say, well, why so? Because they have a shower that works or, you know, they have a telephone line or a WLAN internet for Bindung. What makes a venue good? What makes a venue good is always the people who come to see the show. And if the people who come to see the show are not interested and not into the show and are not having a good time, then it's going to be a bad show every time, whether it's a huge venue or a small venue. If the people who come are not into the show and we can't react with them on a dramatic level, then it's going to be a bad show every time. Some of the best shows we've ever had are for maybe 20 or 30, 50 people. Because you get the interaction with the audience, and it's like, and for us, the audience is a very important part. We like to talk to the audience, we like to yell at them, we like to insult them and everything to get them into the show and get an interaction, you know. There's no glass screen between us, like the, you know, Bertolt Brecht and the Alienation, you know that? the Kalkasches, the Kleiderkreis, all that, you know. You know your classical German literature. I hope you do. But he said that there was an alienation between the audience and the band, as if there was a glass screen, like, you know, as like the showing off, yeah. Yeah. But the Zuschauer, nicht den Zuschauer, is in Mitarbeiter, yeah.
Okay, that brings me to another. Oh, it's really good. It brings me to another point. So you've been traveling all over the world, and but is there still a place on earth you would like to play?
Ah, yeah, that's easy. Australia.
You haven't been to Australia?
To Australia, never been. And Jake or bands like this who are bringing band kids in to discover the older bands, Toasters, Scatolites, whatever. But in Europe, it's there's a much bigger groundswell of support for ska music amongst older people. So the first difference is that the people coming to see the shows in Europe tend to be a little older. That's not to say there's not young kids too, but the demographic is wider in Europe. But then within Europe, each country is different. Like in Spain, for example, they like reggae and they like two-tone, ska punk not. In Germany, they'll listen to a little ska punk. In Italy, it's only reggae. In Spain, only reggae and a little bit of two-tone. So each territory is very, very different. And what that makes you understand about Europe, even though they say Europe is one land, it's not. You know, it's different countries and different tastes and different degustation and different ways of looking at it. So you have to approach each country in Europe as a different entity.
Yeah, that's what I think. I heard about that you have got a base in Spain, that you recorded an album in Valencia. How was it, the connection to Spain, to Valencia? And I heard about your label, that you have the label and office in Spain. Is it right?
Yeah, that's right. I moved to Spain with my family 5 years ago. I voted with my feet, as we say, because I didn't like what was happening in America, and I didn't like what was happening in New York. So I took my family to Valencia in Spain, where I've been living for 5 years, and it's great. So we do a lot of work down there right now, and we involve a lot of Spanish musicians, and we use a recording studio there. So it's a great place to live.
And even there's some more sunshine than in New York, isn't it?
Yeah, I have an orange tree in my backyard.